You may think that to create a new revolutionized product, you need to reinvent the entire system on every detail. But is that really the case? Each individual part of HX50 holds its own piece of importance in the entire project. But there are some things that are vitally important, not only for HX50, but for any other helicopter that is in current production. The main rotor system is one of these.
It's easy to look at HX50 and think, wow, that thing looks like a spaceship. It must be super modern everywhere. When that's really not the case, that's not what we set out to do at all. HX50 was always envisaged to be like a greatest hits album. So it's all the best bits of proven technology from the preceding decades of learning and field proven experience that we've got on all sorts of helicopters, both civil and military. And bringing those together into a product that just does the job really well.
Currently, Craig is assembling the first main rotor system of the HX50. This is in preparation for the event in December, and it is truly an amazing thing to see the HX50's rotor system coming to life in reality.
What we set out to do with HX50 is design a machine that's entirely focused on the needs of inexperienced owner-operator pilots. So these are guys that can't be guaranteed to make all the right decisions all the time, and the machine needs to be as benign as it's technically possible to be in all of those circumstances. So we wanted a rotor system that had got a flapping hinge offset, so it needed to have three or more blades. We went for three blades simply because it's the simplest, cheapest hub you can have with more than two blades. We wanted to have a relatively modest flapping hinge offset so that you've got benign handling qualities, so that you hadn't got so much cyclic authority that you can flip the thing over on the ground really easily. But you'd got enough authority in low G maneuvers that the helicopter was still perfectly controllable in pitch and roll. And so we baked all of those kinds of characteristics into the design of the rotor hub. And once you go after a hub that gives you low drag so you can fly fast, and you set some of these other parameters that give you your handling qualities, that really defines a lot of what mechanical implementations you can consider.
So now that we understand that HX50's main rotor system is something that is an old, proven and reliable system, what makes it rise above the rest?
The clever bits in the rotor hub is how we've managed to cowl that in, how we've managed to get the aerodynamic drag down, because a lot of the forward flight performance of HX50 is about having a rotor system that's really tightly cowled, has a very low drag coefficient, a very low drag profile, so that we can cruise with modest power requirements at very high speeds. And so, yeah, it's very much about just bringing proven technologies together and then making something do a job really well.
If you create something that has incredible design, packaging, and aerodynamics, but does not prioritise safety, then it becomes completely null and void. This is why we prioritise safety with the HX50.
The rotor system that we've developed is a high inertia rotor system. There's a lot of mass up there in the rotor system, and the strap-based design and the composite blades allow us to optimize that mass distribution, so you've got the highest possible polar moment of inertia, so that you've got the longest possible amount of time to get the helicopter into auto-rotation in the event of an engine failure, and then the easiest flare and cushion at the bottom of the auto-rotation, again, to make the helicopter as easy to fly as possible in the hands of people that don't do this sort of thing all the time.
Over the coming weeks, HX50's main rotor system is going to take shape in the realm of reality.
It's old, proven technology. It's easy to design, it's easy to make, it's cost effective. It's a really safe way of making a rotor hub that gives us nice benign handling qualities in a way that there's very little technical development risk for us. So it's a very simple, very elegant hub that does everything that a light helicopter rotor system needs to do.